there's a jet flying somewhere. Or she bought a ticket and she vanished in the sky. How was I to know she...
My name's Rich. I'll be back at the soundboard. Let me know if there's anything I can do to make you more comfortable. And we have a great night of music lined up for you. Before I say anything more, let me introduce the organizer of this show, Terry Rowland.
Thank you. Welcome, everyone, and thank you for coming on out. This is kind of a special night for many reasons, but first up, this is part of a series called the Roadhouse series that was actually started 6 years ago at the Coffee Gallery backstage. Please. Our last show we did there was about 2 months ago. And so Bob Stain had a health problem and had to close down and retire. And we kept him in our prayers. And I've talked to Bob recently, as early as yesterday, and he's doing wonderfully. So he's going to recover. He's going to be in good shape. So we decided we would ask around, and the Fred House, the historic, legendary Fred House, welcomed us with open arms for the Roadhouse series. Tonight, for this series of the show, this edition of the show, we want to dedicate this to Mr. Bob Stain. The Roadhouse series began, it was actually a brainchild of myself and Bob and another singer-songwriter. His name is Patrick Carrico. He's from this area, actually, a rockabilly guy. And we actually just wanted to draw people in to enjoy different genres of music. So the Roadhouse metaphor became this kind of traveling thing that we go from artist to artist, genre to genre, and we explore and we spend one evening dedicated to that particular subject. So the themes are different. Our first one was the Hank Williams. And then we did one for Buddy Holly, and we've done it for Bonnie Raitt. And we've done rockabilly nights with the Ronnie Mack, the legendary barn dance. We've had some just great, great fun and great shows. So we're continuing this now, then, and we've done the same thing with this tonight. It's for John Stewart. So I'm going to just give you a brief little summary, kind of. I know I may be preaching to the choir. I know there are many people here who probably know a lot about John. I'm going to tell you from my own vantage point a little bit about my understanding of John and why we're here to honor him and why we want to spend this time with his spirit and through his music. John Stewart, actually, one of his last shows was right here in 2007, and I was sitting right there. So it makes this night kind of resonate in a special sort of way. It's kind of a reunion to think about. To understand John, you got to go back to the beginning of the folk era, especially the folk revival of the late 50s. John was this guy who grew up around here, in Pasadena, in Claremont. His father was in the equestrian, horse racing races, and taking care of horses. And so John was at, if you have heard his song Back in Pomona, he talks about this area right here where he grew up. But John was, from the very beginning, as his song said, a daydream believer. And he played music, and he loved to play the banjo and the guitar, and he took up writing songs, learning from people like Woody Guthrie and Pete Seeger. He connected with the Kingston Trio in the late 50s, pitching them songs that they thought were just incredible. His part in the Kingston Trio became such a big thing because he joined them in 1962. How many people know who the Kingston Trio is? You can go out to the person in the street and ask them and they won't know. The Kingston Trio seemed to have just been blacked out of music history almost. It's very strange. But at the time, from about 1957 through to about 1964, they were the biggest musical act in the world. And they came with just their guitars and their voices and these great songs of American tradition, folk tradition. They took what had been blacklisted in the late 40s and they brought it and they made it popular. Songs that were shut out and banned because of the fight against communism were somehow forbidden. And it was the next generation that came along, these guys from the Kingston Trio, along with John Stewart, who started singing these songs again. What was so significant about the Kingston Trio is the long playing album. Not many groups could sell long playing albums the way they did. And that really put them on the map musically. They became so huge and they influenced so many people. And when John Stewart came along, he brought in his original songs. He took Dave Guard's place on the banjo, and that became a really important thing. Now the key to this is the fan base that the Kingston Trio created. There were two guys who loved the Kingston Trio, John Fitzgerald Kennedy and Robert Kennedy. They were fans and they contacted them. They were at the White House. They actually connected. Then in 1963, there was a national tragedy and the nation's heart was broken when President Kennedy was assassinated and died. John Stewart was able to see through something there and he began looking at the American experience in a different way. And he became very close with Bobby Kennedy. So from that period, about now, he left the Kingston Trio, he starts to work solo songs, and he becomes part of Bobby Kennedy's campaign for president. This changes everything because the songs that he starts to create are songs that nobody has ever written anything like this before. They look at the American experience, at the American people, and they look at people who very seldom get any attention at all. And that was kind of part of Bobby Kennedy's campaign, was to speak for the people who didn't have a voice. John Stewart saw that. He was right there by his side as it was happening. So if you remember, those of you who know his songs, The Last Campaign, so he was talking about the campaign workers as they went to help Bobby Kennedy get the nomination for president. So we were tired, we were hungry, we were living on a dream for all forgotten people, never heard and never seen. There would come a time, for a moment they would shine, but it died on the road. So when Bobby Kennedy died, it was another trauma and tragedy that changed the way John Stewart wrote songs, saw America. So from that point on, John and his girlfriend at the time, but who became his wife, Buffy Ford, began looking at slides of American art, especially Jamie and Andrew Wyeth, and they would write these songs. And they wrote and recorded this album called Signals Through the Glass. And has anybody heard this? It's rare, it's hard to find. If you can find it, it should be available, you should be able to hear it online. It's a look, it's a first step into the world, into the prison of John Stewart's vision of America and his art that it became so important through the next few several years actually. So from that point on, then he goes to Nashville and records California Bloodlines with the help of Kingston Trio producer Nick Vinay. And they record it live with some of the best musicians in Nashville. The songs on that album, along with the album that followed, Willard, became part of John's canon of great, great American songs, and they also reflected the Kennedy experience, especially Bobby Kennedy. When you listen to the songs, you'll hear it. And you can hear this kind of tragic feeling that he had about what happened there throughout his entire canon of music. But during that time, he was able to take the broken heart of America, crack it open, or see it open up and see the light come through. And what he saw was us. When he rode on the train with Bobby Kennedy, there was one point where they were in a campaign scene in LA, And this Hispanic guy who was like a kitchen worker in the hotel began running up by the car where he and Bobby were. And he started saying, "Remember my name, Ernesto Juarez." And that ended up in one of John's songs called Omaha Rainbow. I remember the name. Tonight we're gonna just start, we're gonna look at some of that. We're gonna scope his whole career. As you know, he wrote Daydream Believer for the Monkees. That became one of his biggest hits and one of the songs that he considered a throwaway. He later on hooked up with Lindsey Buckingham, who loved his banjo playing in the Kingston Trio, and learned his guitar style from that. And then he took that and they made gold out of it. They made like the biggest time of his career. And beyond that, he kept creating. He kept writing. He never stopped recording. And to the point where the success was all gone, the records weren't selling anymore, but the people loved him. And people would come here, they would come to McCabe's, they would go to the coffee gallery backstage, tells of the tavern up in the Central California where there's a great video. And people would come from all over the world to see him, just to see him, just to be around. So I would like to begin with a gentleman who knew John and played music with him. He's gonna come up and sing one of John's signature songs. I'd like to introduce Tim Dismang.
A New York City girl I'd know, living in the concrete, not the sunlight, living in the New York rain and snow. Oh, there's California bloodlines in my heart, and a California woman in my song. California bloodlines in my heart, and a California heartbeat in my soul. Just to think that I might have never known you, if I had lived my life in Tennessee. Oh, but I could have never let that happen. Oh, you in California are in me. Oh, yeah, there's California bloodlines in my heart, and a California woman in my soul. There's California bloodlines in my heart, California heart in my soul.
Just
you ever wondered where we were before we were born? Just rolling round the heaven like a song. It's been the best of High Sierra. I saw High Sierra sunrise coming home. There's California bloodlines in my heart, and a California woman in my soul. There's California bloodlines in my heart, and a California heartbeat in my soul.
Tim Dismang. Next up is a fine singer-songwriter, Miss Lauren Hart.
the band.
That was Lauren Hart. Thank you, Lauren. Next up is a guy who actually started here on this stage at open mic nights, and he's tonight he's a featured performer. Please welcome Mr. Tim Tedrow.
Thank you.
Woolsey. Very talented vocalist and songwriter, Carmen Jean. And Fish Almost. Thank you.
To find a girl.
looks like home. And the taxi cats of the once patrol of the taxi dancer days, and rock and roll's a sailor in port for just a day. The eyes of sweet Virginia was something I had lost, something how the heart has gone, how the heart is tossed. Hang on to dreams, you ain't seen it all, and I don't want much, I just want it all. I will search forever here among the stones, or to find a girl who looks like home. Virginia, where headlights on the road, a beacon for the weary heart that hardens as it goes. In the eyes of sweet Virginia, the fields of Kansas lay, stretched to California, hope for better days. Hang on, dreams, you ain't seen it all, and I don't want much, I just want it all. And I will search forever here among the stones, or to find a girl who looks like home. Here among the stones, oh, to find a girl who looks like home.
Give it up to Barrett.
That's why people buy dogs.
Friend Mr. Joel Bennett.
Sycamores grow in the long planted rows, out here to break the April wind. Still the dust it always blows in our eyes and in our clothes, and it's in our very souls, like a song about me and you. The back of my hand started looking like a man way back when I was only 10. Still the lonesome in me cries like a little boy sometimes. You can hear it scream when I come out screaming like the wind. Me and Jim getting thin. Oh, fare thee well to him. Fare thee well now, mama. I'm gonna take good care of him. Me and Jim getting thin. Don't worry.
And the only time I ever saw him mad was when he talked about the war. Me and Jim getting thin. Oh, fare thee well to him. Fare thee well now, mama. I'm gonna take good care of him. Me and Jim. Me and Jim getting thin. Oh, fare thee well to him. There ain't nowhere to run for the oldest little son. Me and Jim getting thin. Oh, fare thee well to him. Fare thee well now, mama, sleep tight. I'm gonna take good care of him. Me and Jim. The oldest living son. Story in the San Francisco Chronicle that of course I forgot to save. But it was about a lady who lived through the good old days. And about these good old days, the old lady replied, "Why, it's just a bunch of people doing the best they could. Just a bunch of people doing the best they could." Said, and they done it pretty up and walking good. Whatever happened to those faces in the old photographs? I mean the little boys. Boys, hell, they were men, standing knee deep in the Johnstown mud in the time of that terrible flood. And they listened to the water, that awful noise, and they put away the things, the dreams that belong to little boys. And the sun is going down for Mr. Bowie. Singing with his class of 19-2. Oh, Mother Country, I do love you. Oh, Mother Country, I do love you. I knew a man named Stewart, spelled it S-T-U-A-R-T, and he owned some of the finest horses I think I've ever seen. He had one favorite, the champion, the old campaigner, and he called her Sweetheart on Parade. But old D.A. Stewart, he's going blind. And he said to the boys at the tack house, "Before I go, I'm gonna drive her one more time." And the people come from miles around. And they stood around the ring. Nobody said a word. Nobody said a thing. Here they come. E.A. Stewart in a wagon right behind. Sitting straight and proud, and he's driving her stone blind. Oh, would you look at her?
Oh, she never looked finer or went better than today. E.A. Stewart and the old campaigner, sweetheart on parade. And the people cheer. Why, well, I even saw a grown man break right down and cry. And you know, it wasn't but a little while later, old E.A. Stewart died. And the sun is going down for Mr. Bowie. Of 1972. Oh, Mother Country, I do love you. Oh, Mother Country, I do love you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Joel Bennett. Yeah. Opening our second set, I'm going to bring up Mr. Randy Miller, Tom Waits' first cousin.
This song is called If You Should Remember Me.
If you should remember me, and all I am is a memory, would you keep a tiny spark burning somewhere in your heart? And looking back on all the years, days of laughter, nights of tears, and if perhaps a bird appears, it will be me who found you here. The rain crow calls to the setting sun, the curtain falls on everyone. All my love is holy art, that I might live within your heart. And say, I don't believe you're gone away. And would you keep a tiny spark burning somewhere in your heart. Tim
Dismang, he used to go to the trio camps, the Kingston trio camps they would do in Scottsdale, Arizona. And at one point he did one of John's, one of the favorite songs of John's called Dreamers on the Rise. And Tim shared with me how after he finished it, John got up, shook his hand, and brought him up and whispered in his ear, "You son of a bitch, you nailed it." Please welcome Tim Dismang.
Thank you.
Oh, she believes the witch is white, racing across the moon. And she believes an angel hides in the corner of her room. And she believes the ship comes home, yeah, singing from the sea. She believes in losers, though. She believes in me. And she believes that the pot of gold marks the rainbow's end. And she believes a light will show a lonesome homeward friend. And she believes the weary soul one day will be free. She believes in the loser's goal. She believes in me. Oh, lightly when so she can fly.
Faithless, hearty sailor, and he's blowing the sail.
mystery train. And I am a receiver. I've got the mark again. Oh, I am a believer in the grace of rain.
Sisterhood in the heartland. A
over yet. Did the ghost of Dallas make you cry? Born star in the Texas sky.
Thank you. California town. The people are in for the evening. I jump into the car, throwing my guitar. My heart's beating time with my breathing. Cause I'm driving on the candy, singing to my soul. People out there turning music in the gold. Well, my brother Jim Bass, working pumping gas. He makes two fifths for an hour. He's got rhythm in his hands. He's tapping on the cans. He sings rock and roll in the shower. When he's driving on the can, sings in my soul. People out there turn the music in the door. Yeah. never going back. Never going back to Nashville anymore. Oklahoma City, yes, don't you think so?
Never going back.
John. Come on, man. Hey, John.
We have one more.
Now one, we were dreamers on the rise. We were the sun, where the sun never shines. And we would go where the night would only fly. And it's a long time, you know, for the kind of wind to blow. A long time ago, we were dreamers on the rise.
Then twice, we said we'd begin again. We made a vow, all that we'd remain as friends. Falling down, we said we shall rise again. Well, that's a long, long time, you know, the kind of winds are blowing. A long, long time.
Dreamers on the rise. A long time ago, we were dreamers on the rise.
yeah, when the sun never shines and we will go.